video I want to go over the mods I'm using, because it was a bit of a hassle to install this, because well, let's dive into it, what I'm using and what is causing the hassle. So if you look at my mod configuration, you see I'm using Sky UI and I'm using the special edition of Skyrim, and for that you already need a new version of Sky UI, but that actually works kind of fine. However, there were some problems with, for example, the Frostfall mod showing up here incorrectly, and I installed some tools fixes, and that made sure that I now also have the Crossfire mod fully working in the special edition, and also with the meters. You can see on the screen I have all kind of meters which indicate which are related to the Crossfire mod. So let's dive into how I did install all of this. I don't want to log in. This was not intended. Back. Okay, let's quit. So this video will consist of two parts, and the first part is that I'm going to explain how to use the Frostfall mod with Campfire, etc., in such a way that it works with Sky UI and that also the meters are working. In the second part I will go over all of the other mods, because I'm going to start a playthrough with these mods, so it would be a good idea to know how they work. So first things first, if you want to install, I advise of course to use the unofficial Skyrim special edition patch. Note that I'm using Loot and the Nexus mod manager. In essence, you can do everything with this Nexus mod manager and Loot. So if you want to install, first we're going to focus on installing Sky UI. So what you need to do is to download the Skyrim script extender, and on this page they completely explain how to do it. And after you have done that, you always need to start a game with the SKSA64loader.exe. You always have to start up the game with that from now on. Then at Nexus you have the Sky UI mod. So what you get is that you have a much cleaner inventory screen. So that's just self-explanatory, you can just follow the steps listed here. And then it comes down to installing Campfire and Frostfall in the usual way. But what you can do is go to this page, the SSA unofficial update for Frostfall, because there they essentially explain the steps. So first install the original Campfire 1.12.1 for the special edition and Frostfall for the special edition. Then install Papyrus Util and override if asked. So you can also download the Papyrus Util from Nexus. Then you have to install this mod, and with this mod they mean this SSE unofficial update for Frostfall. So you can download that here, and you have to override everything when asked for it. And then if you launch Skyrim, you will have Frostfall in the Sky UI, and you can also enable the widgets in game. So that's basically it. So it's not really that complicated, and the problems people were facing is, for example, a dollar sign on I need and the menus and all kind of topics on the internet, and it's all good and all, but in the end, at the moment, you can fairly easily get everything of this working. So now we go to the second part of this video, because I'm going to do a playthrough and I want to let you know which mods I am using. Well, what I'm using is basically I'm using some kind of home from the Creators Club, but I'm also using an official patch, campfire, flora overhaul, then a diverse dragons collection so that the dragons that appear in the game are more diverse. I'm using a different world map, then the I need mod, and this is adds hunger and thirst and the need to sleep to the game. Then I'm using also sleep to gain experience, which means that we do not automatically level up, but we need to sleep in order to gain experience, and that's also similar to the survival mod made by Bethesda. Then we also have realistic animals and predators. Then CFTO, this is a mod that adds other transport options, more transport options, because we are going to disable, which you can see further below, we are going to disable fast travel. That's another mod, so that's why I installed this mod, the CFTO, because in that mod we can have more realistic other travel options besides the fast travel, because the fast travel is disabled. Hunterborn, then you can extract other things from animals, more stuff. Then of course Frostfall, which emulates the cold and the weather, etc. Then I also added fishing mod, because I thought, well, we are going to play a survival game, so it's handy if you can fish. And also using the alternate start, and I basically use this to skip the tutorial intro scene. Then realistic weather is just for graphical sakes, and vivid weathers to have a nice weather system. And I sort everything with loot. So if you have any questions about my mod list, feel free to ask. I can give you more links, more explanations, etc. But this setup, as how it is right now, is working very well. Thank you all for watching, and I hope to see you in my playthrough.